In this Bluehost review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about Bluehost before deciding if they're the right hosting provider for you. I'm going to provide you with an honest and most comprehensive review where I will break down the pricing structure and show you how to get the best deal currently available with my neat little trick not many people know about. I will guide you through the entire sign-up process and judge how easy their platform is to use. I will then grade their performance based on page load speed and uptime from the Bluehost plan that I purchased. Lastly, I will provide you with the pros and cons and my honest recommendations on if or who should buy Bluehost. At the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up Bluehost through my link. I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free as a way of saying thank you. In this course, I show you how to set up your WordPress website the right way, how to adjust and tweak settings for optimal website performance, and how to start driving traffic and make money from your site. Now let's get straight into this review. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special Bluehost discount page where you will get the best discount Bluehost is currently offering. Plus, just in a moment, I'm going to show you a neat little trick to get an even better discount than this. Now click on Get Started. I will be comparing their shared hosting plans, although Bluehost also offer other types of hosting like dedicated hosting or VPS hosting, so they can support you when your business grows and you are ready for an upgrade. There are four shared hosting plans. With the basic tier, you are limited to one website and 50 gigabytes of storage, and automatic backups is not included. The next plan is the Plus plan, which comes with the added benefit of having unlimited sites and storage. The last two plans, which is the Choice Plus and Pro plan, comes with the handy automatic backup, and the Pro lets you have the dedicated IP, which I don't think is necessary. What I think Bluehost lacks here on their two most expensive plans, the Choice Plus and the Pro plan, is the increase in speed, which most other hosting providers offer as an incentive to upgrade. So I really see no value in choosing their more expensive plans here, as you really only get the advantage of the site backup, which can be done with free plugins anyway. That being said, in terms of pricing, I would only buy the basic plan if you only need one website. But if you require multiple websites, then the Plus plan is enough for you. Don't waste money on their more expensive plans. So now I will choose their basic plan for this tutorial to test them out. Now I have a problem with domain names these hosting providers charge you. Other YouTubers won't tell you this and it really annoys me, so I'm going to be honest and break this down for you. I really don't suggest you buy your domain name from any hosting provider, as they usually charge you much higher than a dedicated domain name provider. Right now for Bluehost, even though the domain name and domain privacy is free for the first year, every year after that, you will have to pay $17.99 for domain name renewal and $14.88 for domain privacy renewal. This total is going to be $32.87 every single year, and I think that's ridiculous. Bluehost is not the only one guilty of this. All web hosting providers do this to you. So what I recommend you do instead is to buy all your domain names from Namecheap.com, and you can get your domain name for under $8.88 with domain privacy included for free, and it will only cost you $12.98 to renew each year, which is almost three times cheaper than Bluehost. So that is a no-brainer for me. Plus, you get to have all your domains hosted in one place, which makes it very convenient when you ever want to do anything to them. Now, if you need help with getting your domain name from Namecheap, then you can check out this video here where I guide you through the process step by step. So I just put in my domain name and click next. Now you just need to fill out your personal information and come down to the more important part here. Bluehost comes with 12, 24, and 36 month payment plans. Obviously, the longer the deal, the cheaper it gets. Generally, I would always suggest you to buy the 36 month plan, as you get the cheapest price and you will have no reason to leave once you have picked a great hosting provider that you are happy with. But if you're not, then Bluehost has a 30-day money-back guarantee so you can get a full refund. I also want to let you know, if you get this free domain name from Bluehost, they will still charge you for that part, as the domain name cannot be refunded. So just be careful with that. Now I will show you a quick little discount trick that people don't tell you about. What you need to do is move your mouse all the way out of the screen. So if I move it to the top, then this special sign up offer will appear. And right now you can get Bluehost for as low as $2.65 per month. So I'm going to click claim savings. And if we go down, you can see that my price has changed to $2.65 per month. And the rest of these you definitely don't need. And what you do is go to the bottom, fill out your payment information, agree with their terms, and click on submit. The overall pricing score I would give Bluehost is a 9 out of 10. I took one mark off as their more expensive plans don't offer enough value to be worth the money. On the other hand, their low tier options are very cheap when you use my little trick, and it is comparable to other cheaper hosting providers, so I would say they are a really cost effective hosting provider overall. After purchase, setup, and ease of use. You're probably wondering what Bluehost backend actually look like and would like to know how easy it is to install and manage your WordPress website, right? I'm going to log in and show you that now. Right away, from their homepage, you can see that it looks very easy to navigate with the custom interface compared to the cPanel that most other hosting providers use. I believe navigating through the Bluehost dashboard is very simple. If you need to contact support, just click on this question mark and it will take you to the help page. But if you need to do something technical, you can still click on advanced and it will take you to the cPanel, which is very handy to have. Something that I don't like from Bluehost though, is if you want to create your email address, you think you'd click on email and offers, but this takes you to a paid option where they give you the option to upgrade. And I think this is very sneaky and not good business practice. Whereas you can always get a free email address by going to advanced and then type in email, click on email account, click on create and enter your username, password, and click on create. And that's it. So at least you can see it's very simple to create an email address. So give them a plus for that, but a minus for hiding it. So the next thing I'll show you is how easy or hard it is to install your WordPress site. So to do this, you just click on my sites and you can add a new site here or just go here and click delete site and I'll reinstall the site for you step by step. So now we click on add site, choose your site name, choose your tagline. Now click on advanced and choose your email address. Choose your username. Make sure to pick anything that's not admin because that makes it easy for hackers to get into your website. Get your password in there and now click next. Choose the domain you want to install your WordPress on. And for these free plugins, I suggest you remove them all as they can slow down your website and you may not need them. Now we click on next, and now you can see our WordPress website was successfully installed. That literally took 2 or 3 clicks, so I would say that was a very easy process. Overall, I would score Bluehost an 8 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really like that it's simple to install your WordPress site, and having the option to access the cPanel to do more technical tasks is also very handy. I did take 2 marks away from them because they don't guide you well when setting up a new domain name from another provider and mislead you on things like setting up your free email address. They tend to try and upsell you a bit too much. Speed and uptime performance tests. So after I have installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. The result is 1.5 seconds. This is not the fastest load speed I have tested by any means, but it's not the worst either. I think so far this speed is acceptable as I have not optimized the website yet. So there's still some potential there. So now I will take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size. And don't worry if you're overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I'm also going to install some free plugins to speed up the website. I'm going to first install WP Fastest Cache, which is a speed optimization plugin, and then followed by a short pixel, which is for image optimization. And lastly, I will install the free Cloudflare. This will make it more comparable to what you would actually do in real life. After adding all the design elements and plugins to my website, it now looks like this. The speed is 3.4 seconds, which is a little too slow to be honest. Google recommends a site to load in under 3 seconds, so Bluehost missed that, but not by much. Now, I have also been monitoring the stability performance of Bluehost with Uptime Robot, and can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is a perfect 100%. That's right, 0 minutes of downtime. I didn't expect it to be this good, to be honest, but data doesn't lie, so always test things out. Overall, I would rate Bluehost's speed and uptime performance a 6 out of 10. Their speed just wasn't fast enough, so I had to take a lot of points away there. Other shared hosting providers can give you speed performance almost twice as fast as Bluehost. On the positive side, they are a very reliable host, and their uptime was perfect, and I cannot fault them on that. Support. Bluehost 24/7 customer service team comes highly rated by so many people. So I will test them out by asking them these three different questions on live chat. 1. I will tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. 2. I will ask them a quick question about their domain name renewal costs, but I made sure to choose the wrong question category. 3. I asked them if they could do me a favor and install an SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and have no idea how to do this. For the first question, they were willing to help straight away and scanned the website for me to check for the virus. However, they were not able to remove any virus for me if found. It would cost me $5.99 per month to add this feature. This is not ideal, but at least they can find all the virus for you, and you just have to go to the files individually and remove it yourself. For the second question, they were able to resolve my query in 10 minutes, and that includes the wait time, so I would say that's not too bad. Although their domain name renewal cost is pretty high, which I wasn't happy about. And for the last question, Bluehost did not hesitate to install my SSL certificate and Cloudflare. They immediately did that for me without having to beg them like some other hosting providers. I was impressed with that. However, the actual process did take quite a while longer than I expected. With regards to their response time, I contacted them at 3 different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So their 3 response times were 3 seconds, 1 minute and 31 seconds, and the last one was 3 seconds again. So that averages out to be around 30 seconds overall, which is definitely one of the fastest hosting providers I have tested so far. So overall, I would say their support was great, and I would score them a 7 out of 10. Their support team was friendly and willing to help to a certain extent, and they had one of the best response time even during their peak hours. They lost some points because some things were limited only to upgrades if you needed their help. Their support also took a bit too long to help with some simple tasks like helping me install my SSL certificate and Cloudflare. They had to refer me to another specialist, which I was a little disappointed as I thought this was a fairly easy task. Features, cons. So let me first start off with the cons. This one is the biggest issue for me that I have with Bluehost, and it's their website speed. It is fairly slow compared to other hosting providers in the same budget category. At 3.4 seconds load speed, it's just too slow for me to be viable, especially when its best competitors are loading pages almost twice as fast as this. The second con is they only have one server location, which is in the United States. So for anyone with their main source of traffic coming from somewhere else, the website speed will be slower and so may not be suitable for you. Another con I have for Bluehost, which is not such a big deal for some, but they just annoyed me a little bit with always trying to upsell and making it hard to find free options, like for linking the domain name and setting up email address, which I showed you previously. And the last con that I wanted to mention to you about, which I didn't at the start because I didn't want to put an unbiased view in your head, And this is Bluehost being part of the Endurance International Group, or EIG for short, which is a global conglomerate that buy up web hosting companies and strip down the staff and features to make their business more profitable while the customers suffer. So if you know about Bluehost, you'd know there's always two sides. One side is just promoting Bluehost at all costs because Bluehost pay them a good commission. Whereas the other side, people who care about their customers, will not promote Bluehost so much. But I'm trying to stay in the middle and give you an unbiased review while backing up all my claims with the stats and tests. I don't think Bluehost support has been affected by this, but I think their tech has. When I first started building websites a few years back, I actually started with Bluehost, and their speed and performance was much better than now. So I do think they have gotten a fair bit worse over the years. Features, pros. The first pro that stands out to me is Bluehost's perfect 100% uptime. Even though they are not a fast hosting provider, at least they make up for it a bit by being reliable. Of course, ideally you want both, but there's no point having blazing fast speeds if your site is always down. The second big pro is their intuitive backend system, which I believe is much easier to navigate and use than cPanel, but they also have that option for you if you require. This may not be a big deal for someone like me who has been building websites for a while, but it's a big plus for beginners just starting out. The next pro is their customer support. I think they are one of the best ones out there in terms of response time. They are fairly helpful and are proactive and willing to help also, but with limitations on some features they can offer. Overall, I have given Bluehost an average score of 7 out of 10. They are a reliable hosting provider with a helpful support team. They also have a very intuitive user interface, so this is why Bluehost is not a bad choice for beginners looking to build small websites with low traffic volume. Anything more than that, whether you're expecting to have more visitors or you have been building websites for a while, there are much better options out there for you in a similar price range that is a lot faster. And if you're in this category, then I would recommend you check out my in-depth review on that hosting provider over here instead. Quick question for you, what is your current page load speed? And who is your hosting provider? Let me know in the comments section below. Do you like this level of detail I am providing you in my review so far? If so, make sure to let me know by hitting that like button and subscribing to my channel so you don't miss more videos like this that I release every week. This is a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up Bluehost through my link, just send me a quick email to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll get that six-figure blogger course to you right away. Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step in your business when starting out. So if after watching this review, you think Bluehost is not the right hosting provider for you, then I would definitely recommend this Bluehost alternative. But if you're happy with Bluehost, but still want a step-by-step guide on setting it up, then I recommend this video. So pick the one that's right for you, and I'll see you over in that next video.